I'm not counting the ones in the cars. I'm just talking about down in the greenhouse.
But this is only dealing with the ones that are in the house, right? And this is just the police, not the dispatchers?
Yes. And this here also, and maybe this is too conservative a number, but on years when we have a good year, and man, we only use $600, if I can take that money and move it into a computer, in the equipment side of the house for computer replacement, if we can set up a fund like that, I'd love to be able to do that.
I'm counting rooms and trying to figure out where you're hiding seven computers. I'm counting five rooms max. One in yours, one in the main room.
Booking room?
Right.
Two in, well, there's yours, two interview rooms, got one in detective's office, and one in the room right behind dispatch. I mean, I'm sorry, the sergeant's office.
Come take a peek in.
And that's not even factoring in the computers in the cars.
Right, those to me are the most important. Because that to me is where more work can be done that's not being done.
In the cars?
Yep. Good times.
You're gonna have to throw in another big figure just to have that operational.
Okay.
So yeah, I'd be happy to have that conversation. Telephones. Want to say that was no change from the previous year. We've already been working that back, so hopefully once I get more data, we'll be able to work that back some more. Publications, no change from the previous year. Water went up, and that's because we've been budgeting too low for it. Last year's cost was actually $759. Now, hopefully that price will stay the same.
What's that one for?
It's just the water cooler that we have downstairs.
That's it. Drinking water.
Hmm?
Do it, Mr. Brown. Do it.
Want to get rid of it? You want one of the cheapest motivators I can have for my employees? Fresh water. We can take it out of
here. I think.
See if Brown goes down.
I think we do great filter with our.
I think Kevin Hurst has some very good mountain water, I thought.
I think we do great with water.
It's funny because he comes in and drinks that.
Somebody's got to talk to him about that.
Definitely. Can't have that.
It's colder.
What about a Brita filter?
Sure, we can do that.
Come on.
Impact license fee. That's. Usually goes up a little bit. I put a 10% increase in it to cover any increases. The Orange and Rockland polls,
I like that
went up a lot.
Yes.
And the reason why that went up is because when that whole project was started, there was real no factoring in the cost per each camera through Orange and Rockland. Now over the last 2 years, I've been trying to collect as much data as possible, and I found out right away that we're not budgeted enough to pay for these cameras.
How many cameras?
We have three right now, and we got two more going in.
Is that the power one you're saying? Or
okay.
So we're talking about.
Is it needed, or is there an estimated read?
I don't know how they figured that out. To be honest, it must be an estimate.
I would think so.
Tough to build sound power.
Yeah. Well, this figure here. Last year was $1,349, and like I said, we got the two more going in, so $14 might even be a little too conservative.
Yeah, that's conservative, because you're almost doubling your cameras.
It's always a catch-22 when you get grant money for stuff. It's the cost that follows.
Nothing's for free.
Yeah, it's the cost that follow what you, it's, that you get the grant money for.
But I'll have a better grasp on this once we get the other cameras in, and then we get to see, all right, this is a full year's worth of data, this is what it cost us, and...
Well, what we're going to need to see is more use out of the cameras. The camera's costing us $2,000, then we're only $3,000 worth.
How about the community service scoff laws, pedaling bicycles,
this is what I'm talking
generators?
About. No. Nice. What I'm talking about is one of the things that we were using them for was to assist us, because we can't do loitering, it's just someone spitting, someone throwing trash, da da da. $25, that we need more of. One, it's going to help us stop the littering, stop the loitering, stop the whole line. That help generate the costs to keep these cameras operational for even bigger issues when we catch someone breaking windows and other, you know, acts of mischiefous.
To some degree, you can try to tie in fine revenue to the return on the cameras, meaning that if the cameras cost X dollars, there should be an effort to equate revenue. And again, the judges won't say that, but the prosecutor can.
Right.
That they itemize some of the revenue to the camera value. You know, the camera caught somebody, you know, kicking the door in, and you know, there's a fine in court and all that related to that.
Now, when the money comes from the courts, what can we do with that money?
Well,
for traffic fines.
Well, first pays. It pays for your traffic control estimate that you have in here. But also there should be provisions that it helps subsidize your budget.
Okay. We don't have that right now.
Well, for a long time the village didn't really, for whatever reason. Well, it's not only keep track. I remember when we cut checks across the street, the village would get like in any given month they get like $3,000. The town would get $10,000. And the state would get $10,000 or $15,000. And it was really like out of whack.
And there was something with the paperwork.
The coding, how you code the tickets. But there's also just in general, you know, the courts need to work for both entities. Okay, not to say that the judges aren't, but the prosecution has to.
But also the roads are different where having 9W for the town, They're gonna always pull more money, but talking to our new prosecutor, he is already
some of 9W.
Did we overcome the problem with the ticket itself? That if people failed to pay the ticket, we couldn't go.
That's been remedied.
Okay.
And the prosecutor is going to be working with the courts and the police,
which is good
to make sure that again. I don't want to be known, you know, when outsiders come and we're known as the place the tickets and da-da-da-da-da. I really want to back off the parking because I think that's a bad thing to be known for. I have no problem being known for the place that I can't speed through. You know, that to me is, you know, oh, every time I go, I get a ticket. Well, you're going 60 through Main Street, you're going to get a ticket. But it's the other end that, you know, that's what we have to work on. And that'll come up in the next section. And that's figuring out what to do with Main Street and the parking, because that is an issue that's detracting from our business, I believe. And I don't want to detract from your report. But as far as the cameras go, we're going to need to, but this is all part of the thing you're putting together. We need a better track on what we're getting from the cameras, even if it's non-monetary. We need to know that we went out and we had 30 tickets, and we had 30 tickets. Because if not, there's no point to turn them off. If we're not getting anything with the cameras, and bottom line is, they recycle, what, every 30 days? They're recording?
No, right now it's a week.
A week. So you can't even go back. You know, after 2 weeks, if people aren't watching the cameras and pulling everything off, then we're not getting what we need.
No, it's a good idea.
But we're upgrading them. So
yeah. What's that?
I didn't want to throw that.
Okay. Go ahead.
So you hold your breath for a week that you don't get caught.
Oh!
So the new cameras are changing it.
Oh, yeah. Okay. The upgrades we're putting in right now.
Yeah, significant.
I'm sitting right next to you. You could easily. That's where you're okay. I got you. Thank you.
All right. So, yeah, that's about it on the camera piece. So, yeah, we'll, just like everything else, so once I get all that data in there, we'll be able to really lock that number down. Maybe that's too conservative, but it's better than what we have in there right now. It's way too low. So that's contractual. A little bit higher than last year.
No bullets.
No bullets.
No bullets this year.
Okay.
Billy Close.
Okay.
Next.
Shot.
See what else I could do in this next section.
Oh boy. You want to go to traffic control or.
You mean you're not finished yet?
Yes, sir.
Two more. These are very short.
Two more short.
Yeah. All right. What do you got next on here?
Let's hope it's
traffic control. Let's go to traffic control. All right. One crossing guard. minimal increase on that, you get $7,900 and some change. It's broken down on this, we'll put copies in everyone's boxes tomorrow, so you'll be able to see the breakdown. And then the line painting, we always budget for that, it comes out of this. There is a little note here that it is a little cheaper if we don't do the double yellow lines, that's broken down on here. And parking tickets, a small increase. Total $13,494. Charlie, do you have last year's figures?
12,363.
So a very small increase, and that was just, you know, by nature, those are the increases. I didn't add any new equipment or anything in there. Any questions on traffic control, Mr. Brown?
No.
Okay. On-street parking, one traffic enforcement officer. We did not, it was on last year's budget. It was taken out on the adopted budget. So this year, we got to put it back in. A total of $11,844. The plan is we do now have two traffic enforcement officers, and they will not work more than collectively 20 hours a week. And I broke it down at $12.78 an hour, and I thought tonight's figure was a little bit higher than that. We can work with that. But you got $11,844, and that wasn't on last year's. Other than that, the batteries for the meters, a small increase on just the cost of the batteries and the miscellaneous and the parking tickets. And of course, to replace meter housings, we usually get at least six a year, and a small increase on that. Actually, I think I kept them the same. So the total for on-street parking is $14,632, Charlie, and what was last year's?
14?
Yeah, that's because you didn't have the parking enforcement. That was the big change. Any questions on that? Again, I apologize I didn't have copies for you tonight, but I will make copies tomorrow and have them in all your boxes so you can analyze it and not cut from it, but add to it.
But the, if you can get us a number on the, whether it's rough or not, the money you're pulling in from traffic and the money you're pulling in from meters.
For this year or last year? And didn't you get some of those numbers?
Yeah, they're increasing.
Yeah.
That goes to the next question, and that is that the prosecutor's commitment as to what revenue the prosecutor's estimating. Did you get a number from the prosecutor?
I didn't. I talked to him about it. He didn't understand, so I explained to him that it was a. We don't need the exact. I can give you an exact number. I'm like, no, that's not exactly what I asked you. I asked you for the estimated amount.
No, but the condition of the fixed compensation was an understanding that the revenues would exceed. And again, the prosecutor can control us much more. You know, the judges won't, but the prosecutor can. My recommendation is. And I'll throw this out. I'm sure the prosecutor will probably give me a call. But 2012-2013 revenues were about $32,000. This year, I have to see what they're tracking, but I can't imagine that they're less. So I think a fair estimate might be $35,000 to $40,000. And what that will do is that will pick up your fixed costs of about $28,000 for these two, both traffic control and on-street parking. That's the minimum. You want to at least pick up the fixed costs there. And then also the variable cost of the salaries. So if you get 30, you've paid for those functions.
Right.
If you get 40, you are paying for the additional cost of the prosecutor and then the benefit of going that route versus what was going on before. Okay, and one of the things that the towns put out that's an error is Jason Menard does not do the prosecutions. It's his firm that does them. He's got a hired attorney, yeah, that's doing it for him. Okay, so there was some discussion about the village, you know, firing Jason Menard. The village fired the firm, but not fired, but made a change.
Yeah.
Jason Menard didn't do any of those prosecutions, whether it's the village or the town. It was a hired attorney for them. I just wanted that clear because somehow there was a statement being made that somehow Menard was being thrown out into the street, and that's not a fair statement.
As far as, I don't think we've looked into it enough, and that's something we really have to look at is the effect of the parking meters on Main Street. I don't believe that they're as essential on Main Street as some people think. I don't think when we balance the two, we're really seeing any kind of an income from it compared to having someone pulling the meters, countering it out, doing the whole nine with the money coming in, as compared to issues of having to give out a ton of tickets and having people going, oh, I got another ticket. The goal is to maximize the use of Main Street. That's the goal of the meters. I truly believe that the only people that are abusing the Main Street parking is a majority of the workers, because they don't want to park in the municipal lot. They want to park in front of their own store. So that's something we need to look at for the future, because we can always chalk for the two-hour parking, and we'd always get ticket then without the meters. I believe cleaning the streets and the visual appeal, we can do a lot to Main Street by getting rid of them. That's a goal of mine. Right now we're dealing with, you know, we've cut a couple down, and we're able to try to do it efficiently, but that's something I definitely want to look towards for the future, just so you know. Anything else, Kenny?
No, sir.
Any other questions?
Wednesday, fire department.
Yep.
We'll also we'll talk about some of the incidentals that are still in here. And through the rest of the week, I'll narrow down a lot of the other stuff in the budget, so that next Monday we have a pretty good blueprint of where we're at, and then where we got to go from there as far as how we're gauged to the 2% cap and where
and
we sit.
We'll have year to date expenditures.
Yeah, do you mean as far as individual lines?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can get those all, the expense registers printed out. Do you want them? My question would be, do you have specific ones, or do you want every, because there's a lot of documents. Do you want specific areas where you want expense, like maybe what the police department has, let's say, on their salaries, and then contractual, or broken down to individual, specific codes? You know, I need to know how much you want to drill down, because you're talking about nine months worth of data.
Well, can you take the codes that you've already got on volume B and just add a column for year-to-dates?
I could. The time, I'll have to see if I can do that by next Monday. I'll try, because I can't import it. Everything is basically pulling it off of KVS and then putting it onto the spreadsheet. It's not like I can just import the line and say, okay, give me a query. Yeah, give me a query for everything in KVS.
Well,
that's why it'll be nice to have KVS to do the budget in the future, because then that's easy.
As we go through trying to get a better fix on where things might be cut, can you query it on your computer and give us a number?
The problem is I'm not connected to KVS here. Okay, KVS is going through the server, so I have to be hardwired. What I'll do is, last year there were certain expense registers that were printed out. I'll try to see if I can narrow it down to the ones that were maybe done last year and see how that works. Some of the ones there probably is no debate on. You know, like some of the stuff that's in here, when you look at like some of the expenses, like historian, does anybody want to break down the historian's expenses? You know, so some of these things are probably less important. Salaries are what they are. Overtime, we've discussed. So I'll see if I can drill down on some of these things. And then worst case scenario, when we're in the discussion and we decide on a code and we need information, I'll just go print it out on demand. Okay, so that we just get the report based on what we're looking at that time.
If you could just send an email out to Kevin and Johnny, so they can get copies to us of the breakdowns they had during the report, similar to what Ken had, just so we have the individual items, and then you'll give us those, and then that'll be that way when we start. God, I'm vicious. I know exactly what I'm doing.
Yeah, and then again, look at some of the areas where there've been pretty good plus ups to determine your priority scheme as to what can be cut first, second, third. You know, if you noticed some of the bond debt that has to be paid is ballooned. Mm-hmm. A couple of them I told you guys about.
Right.
Okay, those have as much impact. Those have as much impact as your light duty guy.
Yeah.
As far as dollars. We also have the bond issuance. And I mentioned I'm trying to find a way to maybe look at the bond issuance in a way that we can pay it, but we can pay it through the capital fund. I have to see about the priority of all that. But if it is something that's available, we'll certainly consider it. So there are a lot of things we can do. I think still the biggest thing the board can do between now and the end of the year is to really focus on the overtime. Okay, because that's, again, as the police chief has demonstrated, you know, paying close attention to that, there is some opportunity there. You can also factor in a consideration on suspending, you know, supplies, things like that, you know, maybe a little more justification for that. But there's going to be, if you want to do certain things that have been brought up by the public, like the senior center, and, you know, if the contract is resolved, then the liability costs for the contract, we're going to have to find money from other areas for that. And, there, you know, there's challenges. So just we have essentially Wednesday, Monday, and Wednesday of next week, and if we're still struggling, we can always put a Saturday in there before we have to get this thing kind of wrapped up the week after, so it can go to the clerk for publishing. Okay. If you have any individual questions, call me or send me an email.
Is there any debt we could retire? Any long-term issues that are higher, you know, interest rates that we could?
Well, in the refunding of the serial bond, that did a lot.
Yeah.
The one thing when you do that, you have to make sure that there's enough spread between where you're at and where you're going, because there are inception costs and costs associated with that. As we found with Munistat, we have to pay $1,250 a year for them to do the FCC filing, so the bondholders get the picture of the village's health. That's an annual cost with that. Again, it makes complete sense to do the refinancing because you get a much lower interest rate. So the long run, it's a minimal cost for the amount of money that you save. Water meters were paid this year. There's a couple bands that are slowly, you know, working their way to maybe a couple more payments. Web Lane Bridge, I think we have one or two more payments with that. Before that is done, although it's my estimation that might rear its head again, because there might be some work that needs to happen in the future.
Didn't do a great job.
Yeah, on Web Lane Bridge. So there is some stuff there. But the other thing too is, as I mentioned earlier, with all the spending that the village has done on this infrastructure, water tanks, grid systems, and all that, the maintenance costs and the repair costs should dramatically go down. So you should be able to find money in less expenses to help pay the bond debt. And ultimately, increased revenue is the cure of all ills.
Oh, here we go.
Okay? Let's find revenue. You know, there's many ways we have to be, you know, willing to do it, but there's many ways. Water customers, Fort Montgomery is going to be showing up with water customers, with the hookups and so on. Okay? Glad to have it. I think the board's done a nice job following up with some of our delinquent water and sewer customers, or ones that, you know, feel like somehow they're not using the water even though the meter says they are. You know, but it is what it is. The meter, I will say this too, the meter purchase, I think is going to pay itself off quicker than I think people might think.
Electronic meters.
Absolutely, because it's much harder to. It's much harder to work the system, as I say. Electronic meters don't lie.
No.
So it's a cleaner way to get your revenue. So that's in a nutshell. It's a lot of opportunities. Just looking at the budget, you know, my first year looking at it, I think there's a lot of opportunities to hit the revenue side and the expense side, but you're not in the easiest position. And the state hasn't helped with the 2% tax cap. And as a taxpayer, you're welcoming that, but the problem is the state hasn't decreased any of the mandates. Officers still have to have X things done, number of bullets shot, liability has to be here, workers' comp has to be here. Now the state has an extra surcharge now on workers' comp that's about $5,000. Health insurance.
The MTA payroll tax.
MTA payroll tax, health insurance, you know, all these things are continuing to grow out there. So you gotta find ways to do that, to get the revenue. So our new prosecutor hopefully will
bring in the big bucks.
Yeah. Put some pressure on them.
Right.
Okay, so that's all I got.
All right.
Motion to adjourn.
So move.
Yay.
Not even a second.
I won't be here on Wednesday, so I'll work.
Okay.
I won't be here on Wednesday, so you and I can't coordinate.